here goes. The velocity of P is equal to the velocity of A, the origin of your non-inertial frame, plus what we just developed is V-rel.
I see in the students a greater motivation to learn. Starting perhaps a decade ago, I learned a little bit about active learning and tried it in the class a little bit, and I've become quite a fan of it, and it's completely changed the way that I now conduct a class. So I like to say that I teach more and lecture less. When I first started teaching, I taught probably the way most junior faculty begin teaching here at Michigan today. I thought teaching was really lecturing. So I used every second of every hour that I lectured just to talk at my students. And I remember feeling almost panicked if I didn't have something to say. So I would finish an hour or an hour and a half and walk out just exhausted. And I covered everything that I wanted to cover, and then some. And that's what I thought teaching was about. What I realize now is that I wasn't really teaching so much as, yakking. So the one thing is that the students learned more than anything else was that I was very quick at solving problems, which is very different from them learning. I think it's extremely valuable to break up a lecture with a time for them to ask questions and to reflect on what they've done.
Vectors for all of the relative.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, because in the relative frame, you are in that frame. Meaning it takes time. I can't do as many examples as I did before, but I believe they're learning a whole lot more than they were before. They tell me so in course evaluations. I see evidence of that on exams, and I know they are engaged. It's typical that I get 90% of my students attending lecture, regardless of whether or not I'm teaching 140 students or down to a class of 60 students. It's an absolute blast, honest. Yeah, sure. Do it for the selfish reason that it's fun, because it really is fun.